Praise the Lord, you are tuning into the media ministry of Apostle Barbara R. Thomas. This ministry is designed to bring forth revelation and encouragement and to enlighten your minds. Now listen as the woman of God brings you revelation from the Word of God.
The Lord told me many times the people are caught up destruction and disasters because when he spoke, they did not move. Wow. And the Lord began to say something to me. He said, now the Jones that have been scattered will get to their rightful place. He said, now the Jonas that have been scattered are going to get to their rightful place now. Because he has been calling people out to the places that he has ordained for them to be.
Yes.
And many people would not move, Apostle Mike, because they were comfortable in where they were at.
That's right.
And he said, even they wouldn't move, even though they seen what deems to be success. He was yet calling them out because there's a people that have not heard the good news as of yet. And so the Lord told me, he said, don't be afraid of the storms. He said, don't be shaken by them. Even as I was coming this way, I got all kind of phone calls, texts and stuff. You on your way to Florida, and they say it's coming. I said it might be coming, but it ain't gonna come till I leave.
That's right.
I said, because the Lord has me on assignment. Y'all wouldn't let me strike. I said, nothing can happen to those that God has fashioned in this hour. Oh, y'all ain't saying nothing. Hallelujah. See, people are caught up, and the Lord began to tell me, he said, many of the prophets are prophesying, hallelujah, from a fearful place.
Yes, sir.
He said, they're not hearing me. Y'all ain't saying that. He said, they're prophesying out of fear. Because the Lord began to tell me, he said, just like I told you, if you would just come before me for 7 days and just come and consecrate a certain amount of time each day, just come before my presence. He said, I can turn anything. And the Lord began to tell me, he said, I sent prophets. the people. I sent them to prophesy. I sent them to tell the earth to repent. I sent them to tell the people to turn from their wicked way, and they would not take heed, but they believed the other prophets. And Jeremiah said, hey, holy, if it come to pass, then he'll be alive. But if not, glory, because he began to prophesy and said that God was not going to allow what was prophesied to come to pass.
That's right.
Come on, Apostle.
Y'all better hear me real good.
Yeah.
Oh, God. Because in order for us to have a new beginning, God got to destroy some old things.
That's right. That's right. Completely. That's right.
He got to destroy some old things in order for a new beginning, in order for rebuilding, in order for restructuring. It's got to be some things torn down.
That's right. That's right.
And y'all looking at me crazy.
Yes, yes.
And I said, God, I don't really want to preach right now, in this hour right now, this season, this right now, because he's giving me something different than what he's saying to other people. He's giving me something different. Y'all ain't saying that. Hallelujah. Because now he said, when you go on with instructions and directions.
Yeah,
and to speak my word out of your mouth.
Amen.
And see, people want a smooth word, and they want a good, feel good message. But we can't feel good until we get in the good.
Oh,
hallelujah. Look at somebody and tell them, you can't get feel good until you get in the good. Hallelujah. So we thank God. Hallelujah. And it's just so ironic that you would have a celebration in the midst of what they say is supposed to be destruction.
I love it. That's good.
And see, the Lord began to deal with me, and he said, that's prophetic. He said, that's prophetic. You got to understand. I put you in the midst of a celebration when it's supposed to be destruction. Y'all ain't saying nothing. He said, I put you in the midst of a celebration when it's supposed to be destruction. Because see, when you know your God, you can still celebrate. Y'all ain't saying nothing. Hallelujah. And so the Lord began to tell me, and he began to take me to the book of Daniel. Hallelujah. And I'm going to have to do this because they ain't tall enough to stand behind that thing right now. Ain't tall enough to stand behind that. I can't all see my Bible. Hallelujah. I'm just that short. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Lift your hands and tell God thank you. Hallelujah. Because now the Lord is getting ready to do something. Hallelujah. And the Lord began to speak to me. He said, in this hour, I'm getting ready to send Gabriel. He's the messenger. He's the messenger, and he's coming now with a message for the earth. Y'all ain't saying that. And he began to tell me, he said, the angels are getting ready to show up. Hallelujah. I'm talking about real angels are getting ready to show up in our services with a word from the Lord. Because see, we won't hear man. So he got to send his angel. Oh, y'all ain't saying that. Hallelujah. So he's getting ready to send the angels now to speak in the earth.
Yes.
And the people, oh God, God began to tell me, he said, even those that see the angels still are not going to turn.
Right.
He said, even when I send them with a message, you still going to have a remnant that's going to sit there and say it's not so.
Wow.
He said, the opposition that has been in the church is because the people don't want to hear the real word of God. They don't want not Saul, who knows? Hallelujah. And so the Lord began to tell me, he said, even those that are prophesied, he said, you got to watch out, because some of these people are not prophets, they're sorcerers.
Ooh.
He said, and they're releasing. Hallelujah. Because you got to understand, we're in a time in the season now, because it's getting ready to be a new year in the calendar, the Jewish calendar. Y'all ain't saying it. It's getting ready to be a new year. And right in this time, the enemy is doing everything he can. And the Lord began to tell me, he said, you got to understand, hallelujah, what I showed you when I showed you that vision. And I showed you and I showed you when you had people that were at the water and they were doing things to the water. And the Lord began to tell me, he said, some of this is illegal.
Wow, come on.
It's illegal. He said, because remember, I set borders, which meant the water wasn't supposed to come past what I said.
That's right.
Y'all ain't saying nothing. Hallelujah. No matter what it was, it was when it comes, anything gets out of the order of God, it will cause calamity and chaos.
Yes, come on.
And he began to tell me, he said, this is an illegal flood that's taking place. He said, the people are not going in the spirit to see what's going on. He said, they're looking, but they don't understand that the enemy right now, he said, because you got to understand, they're worshiping the queen of heaven. She rests in the water. Yeah. She rests in the water. And right now the enemy knows that we are in a season right now where God is getting. You know what? Hallelujah. Even though it's going to be chaotic, it's also going to be a celebration for those that know God. Y'all ain't saying that? Yeah. Huh? Hallelujah. Because we're going to be all right. Hallelujah.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. I told somebody the other day, I said, when we had a tornado in Tupelo one time, hallelujah, not too long ago, hallelujah, I said, the tornado came up the street, should have tore up where we was at. I said, but you know, there was not even a limb down on the block that I lived on. I said, God told me, he said, if you do this, he said, I'm going to spare your block.
Come on.
Yeah.
And he gave me some instructions, and I followed the instructions. Y'all ain't saying nothing. And right up the street, it wasn't even four houses up. It took everything. Looked like down that alley, down that whole avenue. Y'all ain't looking at me crazy. Hallelujah. And it took a minute. And God told me, he said, I'll spare your house. And he said, because you're on this block, I'll spare the people on your block.
My God.
And when they looked, they were bringing people out. They said, ain't nothing wrong with that. I said, ain't nothing wrong with this street. If anybody on this street tell you something wrong with their house, they lying. I told them.
Right.
I told people. I said, ain't nothing wrong with this street. We didn't even have a branch down once the tornado went through.
Wow.
It didn't even look like nothing blew on our street.
Yeah.
We was trying to figure it out. Hallelujah. The couple of people that were with, they was trying to figure it out. Hallelujah. And I told them, I said, listen, when God tell you something, you just got to obey him. He gave me specific instructions. He told me what to do. He said, if you do this, I'll spare your life, and I'll also spare your belongings.
Wow.
Hallelujah.
So don't tell me God won't do.
Yes, he is.
Come on.
Oh, God. Look at somebody and tell him he's going to spare us.
He's going to spare us.
Because we're going to be all right. Hallelujah. And so he told me this, and he took me to Daniel, the ninth chapter, and I thank God for Apostle Bynes. I thank God for the celebration. Come on now. Hallelujah, because the Lord told me, you're going to find out in this hour who really on his side. Hallelujah, because nobody should have been afraid to come to church.
That's right. You're
not afraid. If he would have spared any building, he would have spared his house.
That's right.
Oh, hallelujah. All right, come on now. If anything go down, he would spare his house. Come on now. Hallelujah, as long as the house is right. Come on. Hallelujah. When the house is right, hallelujah. Hell, come here. Come on now. When the house is right, look at somebody and tell them, you gotta make sure the now begins to pray. Yeah. Oh, God. He begins to pray in this night chapter. He begins to pray because it's a word getting ready to come forth.
Amen.
Hallelujah. And the people of God right now got to get an understanding that the Lord is talking.
Yes,
it is. Yes, it is.
Hallelujah. Yeah. And you better hear the right voices. Come on now. Hallelujah. Y'all ain't saying nothing. Hallelujah. The Lord began to tell me, he said, that every voice that's speaking is not authorized to speak right now.
Amen.
He says, some of them, I've been fired.
Yeah.
But they still act like they hide it.
Yeah.
And that's why the people are in a state of confusion right now. Because they don't know what to do. Because the voices they should be listening to, they're rejecting them. Because even though he'll send a word of comfort to you, even though he'll tell you, he'll also let you know what's going to happen. But if you follow his instructions, you'll be spared.
Amen.
But when I was coming, he began to tell me, he said, now the, and I'm going to say it again, he said, now the Jonas that are scattered will get in their right place. Some people, hallelujah. And you know what? I found out sometimes you caught up in people's judgment.
Yes.
Just by being with them or around them. No, they say nothing. Hallelujah. And you call in their judgment. So he's saying in this hour, he said, tell the people, because right now, people of God, the Lord is talking with a firm mouth.
Yeah.
He's not playing. He got a firm hand on what's going on. Y'all ain't looking crazy now. Hallelujah. Look at somebody. He know what he's doing. Come on. He know exactly what he's doing. Hallelujah. My God, there's nothing that goes on that the Lord don't know about.
That's right.
But when he gives us instructions, we have to follow the instructions that are given. Oh, y'all ain't saying that. And the reason why we are in trouble right now is because when he sent the instructions, we would not take heed. How long has he been telling us repent?
Right.
Yeah.
Oh. How long has he been telling us to turn? Oh God. Hallelujah. Jesus. Look at somebody and tell you, you gotta know who to listen to in this
hour.
Y'all listen to all them folks that's trying to get your money.
That's right.
All they're trying to do is get your money. Hallelujah. But look what he says in Daniel the ninth chapter. Because he's talking to God. And he's talking to him in prayer. Hallelujah. See, you got to know what to pray. Look at somebody.
So,
tell you
got
to know what to pray.
You got
to
know what to pray.
You can't get up there trying to act like you God's last wonder on the earth. Come on now. There's something around you, honey. Right. You got to know what to pray. Hallelujah. This is not the season right now to pray amiss. Come on.
That's
hallelujah. You got to pray. Hallelujah. Know what you're praying about, because we're getting ready to experience something. And I don't care what nobody say. You got to understand. Hallelujah. That at the beginning, if anybody understand at the beginning of the Jewish New Year, if they really understand it, that is during the time when God settles in his mind who's going to live and who's going to die.
Amen.
He determines who's going to live, who's going to die. He begins some determination. Hallelujah. Y'all got to hear me now. Hallelujah. So there were some things that he had already established that was prophesied. Come on. Hallelujah. And it began to be prophesied to you. Hallelujah. He gave us a chance because he told us in June, July, and August that we ought to get ourselves together.
That's it.
I believe some things wouldn't have never occurred if we had to listen to him and obeyed him. Y'all understand that? But because we, as a people, hallelujah, don't want to hear the real voice of God when he speaks, because for some reason people got the understanding that God just going to let us do what we want to do and we just going to be blessed anyhow. But there comes a time when he begins to command and demand holiness and righteousness. See, we're expecting, and it's strange and really ironic that just before this new year comes, all this comes.
Yeah.
Y'all looking at me?
Amen.
It's ironic that just before the new year comes in, all of this is hitting the earth right now.
Mm-hmm.
beginning, it was down low and red. Then we looked again, and it was nowhere. And I'm trying to get to the house because I'm in the case of it. You know what I'm saying? He left it. I don't know what was getting ready to go on. Calm down. Hallelujah. And I keep on saying, God, this is unusual stuff happening ever since that eclipse. And things were thrown out. It was thrown out of order. It was thrown into chaos. Fires breaking out. Everything going on. And we're still sitting around. Hallelujah. Still mad at each other. And got attitudes. And jealous of each other. And fighting each other. And saying all manner of evil against each other. When the Lord is saying this is the time for the church to come together. And we're going to do anything. Let's celebrate and pray.
Yes, that's right.
Told the Lord, I said, it's time out now. Hallelujah. And right now, hallelujah, probably everybody looking at me because they trying to figure me out.
Yeah,
they trying to figure me out right now. Hallelujah. And they ain't got an understanding. Hallelujah. Because one thing I told God, God dealt with me. He said, you cannot cover people that's walking in rebellion, disobedience, and sin, and ain't trying to get right.
That's right.
He said, so in this season, you're going to have to cut off some people. Hallelujah. And so, you know, sometimes you make an announcement because I know Facebook is a way for folks to try to terrorize your name. You know what I'm saying? So I made an announcement and some of the people misunderstood. They thought I was thinking I was scared or something. I ain't never scared. Come on now. Hallelujah. The best don't try to destroy me. Come on now. Hallelujah. My name is always wrong. You understand what I'm saying? Hallelujah. Why? Because I'm not being controlled by anybody. Come on now. I don't ever put me in their cliques. Come on. Hallelujah. I don't ever do that to me. I don't ever come to me with a bunch of mess and all that foolishness. Come on. Hallelujah. Because why? We got to set a standard in this hour. Look at somebody and set standards. Hallelujah. You got to walk in excellence in this hour. And the Lord began to tell me, he said, nothing can get the attention of the people but the terror of the Lord. Daniel was talking. He was praying. And long about that 20th verse, he says, and while I was speaking and praying and confessing my sin and the sin of my people Israel and presenting my supplication before the Lord my God for the holy mountain of my God. Yea, while I was speaking and praying, even the man Gabriel, who I have seen in the vision at the beginning, being caused to die swiftly, touched me about the time of the evening oblation. And he informed me and talked with me and said, oh Daniel, I am now called for to give thee skill and understanding. Oh God. Look at somebody and tell him, you're going to need more than that gift operating right now. He said, you're going to have that gift, but you're going to have some skill and understanding in order to be able to operate and function in the way God wants you to function with it.
All right.
Amen. He said, so I'll come forth now to give you skill and understanding. At the beginning of thy supplication, the commandment came forth, and I have come to show thee, for thou art greatly beloved. Or understand the matter and consider the vision. He said, listen, I'm coming. Why? Because you are greatly beloved. Oh God. Hallelujah. Somebody better catch that. Hallelujah. What people don't understand is, can't no devil in hell destroy you when God loves you. He said, this right here
is a trial.
It's a trial.
Yes.
And you know what he said? He said, my people are on trial.
Yes.
See, it ain't about, I keep on telling people, it's not about the sin. It's about the Christian saints. The ones that say that, you know, they saved, sanctified, and filled with the Holy Ghost. And y'all don't say nothing. Hallelujah. The ones that say they got it all together and got relationships with God. And the ones that say they have it all kind of angelic visitations. And you know, and Jesus don't came to them himself. You know no more. The ones they're talking about, they ain't God, hallelujah, they ain't glory, hallelujah. The glory cloud shows up in their house. You know, them folks. Them the folks God is trying to get their attention right now. And we got to understand that we are in an hour right now. Hallelujah. Well, we got to get an understanding of what's going on. But see, Daniel had a special relationship with the Lord because he was a person, hallelujah, that did not compromise. He didn't let down on his belief. Come on now. Hallelujah. Even when they brought him in into that captivity, he would not allow himself to be caught up in the other things that the others was doing. He wouldn't even eat like they ate. Come on now. Hallelujah. Oh my God. Hallelujah. And people run around talking about the Daniel fast. Hallelujah. They think the Daniel fast is for prosperity. The Daniel fast is for you to get understanding and skill. It's not for you to think you're going to be prosperous for the rest of the year. A Daniel fast was recorded. Y'all looking at me crazy. Hallelujah. Oh, come on now. Hallelujah. Was when you wanted to get before the Lord. Hallelujah. Because you needed some answers and some understanding. Hallelujah. And the problem now is the Lord is saying the people are not coming before him to ask him for understanding of what's going on in the earth. They still coming before him asking him for money and power.
Yes, yes.
Come on.
Who's going to be the greatest in the kingdom?
Ooh,
that's their words. Who's going to be the greatest? Who's going to have the most anointing? Who's going to have the most power? Huh? Oh God. Hallelujah. And we are in a season right now where there's so much competition going on.
Yes,
so you almost don't even
want
to preach no more. Yes,
it is.
That's so true.
My God,
yes,
it is. Yes, it is.
Because they just competing against each other.
Yes, they are, Father.
And if you ain't in the clique, they don't want you anyway.
That's right.
Come on.
If your voice don't sound like they, I ain't never wanted to be nobody's clone.
That's right.
And I ain't gonna walk in nobody's shadow but the Lord's. He said, I'll abide under his shadow.
Come on, dear. Nobody's clone.
And we running around here want to be everybody else, but look at somebody and tell them, you better learn your own identity right now. Because you don't even know where some of these people is getting their power from. Some of these folks ain't getting their power from the Lord. Oh God. Hallelujah. And you running around talking about, I want to be just like them, which means you got to go in covenant with the demonic forces that they're empowered with. So the Lord is talking now. Look at somebody and tell him, he is talking. And don't need the folks get mad. He's talking right now. Hallelujah. And so he talks to them. And Daniel is, and why he praying, why he's talking, Gabriel shows up. And the Lord told me that. And I said, oh, wait. And then that's the thing. He just gave me the scripture while I was sitting there.
Wow.
That look at me straight. I'm sorry. I'm not like other people. I don't have no words broke down, nothing like that. Nothing like that.
Right.
Can I just move by the Spirit?
You gotta move by the Spirit,
Pop. I move by the Spirit like I always have done. Hallelujah. And that's why people tell me that they don't want me to teach in their church, because I teach people how to operate in the Spirit and not according to their theological.
Mm-hmm.
I said, that's good when you teach it so you can teach background and different things. I said, but when you get up before the people, you got to let the Spirit move through you. Huh? And people don't like to hear the Spirit, because the Spirit will dictate and everything that's in the house.
Yes,
Spirit knows all things.
That's right.
And if you're not operating with the Spirit, then you're operating in your flesh. And half the time, people are preaching for what they don't heard and not what they know.
Come on, Apostle.
That's right.
Sometimes they come to your church and they already got the gossip about your church. Don't look at them, be strange. Hallelujah. Just look at somebody and tell them, you got to make sure they're moving in the Spirit too. Some of these people, they ain't coming to do nothing. Oh God. And then you know what? I was telling somebody today, the Lord gave me an assignment. And man of God, prophet, I know I'm going to get in real bad trouble with preachers and everything else, and probably going to get locked down back. You know, what you call it?
Black.
You know, blackballed. Yeah, I'm going to be blackballed. Hallelujah. Because you know what the Lord told me today? He said, when you go into these churches under these leaders that are not of me, he said, if you need my sheep, I'm going to cause their soul to be accounted to you. He said, you go in and bring my sheep out. And this is what is happening now. And this is why they don't want the real prophets to come. Because they're coming to give the people the real word that the Lord is speaking. And many of their eyes are coming open now. And people's eyes are being enlightened right now. Hallelujah. Their mind is being opened up. Hallelujah. And where they were deaf and dumb, the Lord began to tell me to rebuke the deaf and dumb spirit that's in the body of Christ. Because they act like they can't hear. They act like they can't see. And then they act like they got a mental problem.
Right.
He said, you got to release them from that spirit, because that's the spirit that's overtaking the body of Christ. When they see this gift, they're hypnotized, Holy Ghost, and mesmerized by people's gifts. Hallelujah. But they think it's the Holy Ghost. And the reason why a lot of them don't know what the Holy Ghost is, hallelujah, is because they have never encountered him or received him.
Hallelujah.
They had a demonic impartation. And the Lord began to tell me, he said, that's why you got to listen with the Spirit, even when they're speaking in tongues.
Amen. Yes. Yep, thank you.
He said, because their tongues, hallelujah, are coming from a different spirit than Messiah. He said, everybody that you hear in the church, even speaking in tongues, are not speaking from the Spirit of God. But what they're doing is releasing demonic forces in the body of Christ. And we're sitting there, and our spirit is open, and we're trying to figure out why we got messed up in church. You got messed up in church because you didn't guard your spirit, baby.
Amen.
It was you opening up, coming into agreement with something that was not like God. But when you find yourself overtaken, you need to get back to the altar and get delivered.
Yeah. Come on, Apostle.
Hallelujah. You got too many people demonically oppressed. I told them, I've never seen so many people so demonically oppressed as I see in this hour, prophet of God.
My God.
Look at somebody and tell God's about to make an end to some stuff. He said, I need you to understand the matter and consider the vision. I need you to understand. You need some people in this day and hour that are not only seeing, but have an understanding of what they're seeing. And the Lord began to tell me, he said, it's a whole lot of error prophecies going forth right now, because the people are not seeing and hearing in the spirit. They're taking it at, from the natural standpoint, and the reality, oh God, can mess them up, because it looks one way in the real. You understand? In the natural. He said, but they're not seeing in the spirit what's going on, what's happening. He said, even when they're dreaming and they're not waiting to get my interpretation.
Yes. Come on.
And he said, many of the prophecies that are being spoken right now are being spoken before time, because they're caught up in the theatrics of what's going on right now.
Amen. Come on.
Some things weren't supposed to be released yet. And see, when you're not careful, oh God, help me now, because I know I'm getting in trouble with all these prophets. Oh God. He said, if you're not careful, they'll manipulate time and cause something to be burnt before it's time.
Come on, Apostle. Wow.
That's good.
Yeah, that's good.
us getting what God has, we give a whole lot of mutation.
Uh-huh.
And then he began to tell me, and oh God, I'm gonna get in trouble. I know I'm gonna get in trouble. I'm about to mess up the church, honey.
Mess it up.
He said, there are those that are prophesying now with a hidden agenda of destruction. He said, some of the prophets have become lying prophets.
Wow, yes they have, Father.
And he said, they are now lying.
Yes, they are.
He said, and what is happening is many of them have begun to speak things that are causing a collision, that's what he said, in the atmosphere. And then they're coming in agreement with the demonic forces. And they're hearing from that realm. And they're letting it come out of their mouth as if it's a word from the Lord.
Right.
Wow.
Right.
Come on now. Come on.
He said, they're not He said, they're not hearing my voice. He said, that's why they gotta be careful with the voices in your head.
Ooh. Yeah, talk about those.
Because the voices in your head can come in agreement with what your spirit man that is not regenerated yet is in agreement with. Y'all looking at me strange. Your soul, y'all looking at me strange. Y'all looking at me strange. Y'all looking at me strange. Hallelujah. He says, so they're prophesying from the depths of their demonic realms in their soul rather than prophesying from the Spirit of God. Hallelujah. Because he said that they're not perfect in certain areas. They're going to prophesy from that area.
Wow.
So if they're perverse, their prophecies are going to be perverse. If they're a liar, their prophecies are going to be a lie. He said, because they're prophesying from the issues that have not been taken care of.
Come on,
come on, the problem. Ah, the Uncle Slap. We came out the Cosa. And then the Mandy Uncle come under the ocean. I come under the ocean. I cover this word.
Yes.
Oh, God. Against every demonic force right now. Then in the ocean, I command their ears to be stopped up that they won't hear. Remind the ocean, the word of the Lord that will set the captive free. I'm over the Okoshaya. I come against every witch and warlock that's even looking on Facebook as it's being filmed. I bind the Ekosha. I bind up their incantations even now. Every spell, every curse they're releasing in the atmosphere.
Come on,
Apostle. You have sold even your money into them.
Yes.
And help finance their greed and their iniquities. And we must repent.
Amen.
The Lord said the church have gotten caught up in the celebrities of the gospel.
Yes, ma'am. Come on, apostle.
And even when they hear apostle, oh Lord, I'm calling them apostle.
Mm, you got to hear that before.
Even when they hear what the Lord is saying about them because they false, they will not adhere to it because of the popularity. And they'll continue to follow what is false rather than the real. Because the real requires you to have a standard. And that's why they flock to the bigger churches that don't have a real, real, real relationship with them.
Mm. Wow.
Because I can hide in 30,000, but I can't hide in 30.
That's right. That's right.
Uh-oh. 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 Uh-oh.
Okay.
See, Jesus had 12 he dealt with. They couldn't hide. He might have spoke to the multitude and the masses when he was preaching the gospel. But when it came to training, teaching, he had 12 that he really poured himself into.
Oh, y'all ain't saying
that. So we want to have a whole bunch of people, but we can't pour into all of them. Because in order for you to really be able to pour into people, you got to have a personal touch with them. And so we looking for crowds. Oh God. Hallelujah. When the Lord said you need to be looking for your assignments.
Wow.
That's it.
You can teach the gospel to the masses. But when it comes down to you training and teaching, he's not going to give you 50,000.
Right. That's right.
That's looking at me crazy. Because you've got to be able to have a personal touch with them.
That's it.
God.
Wow.
So it's not a whole lot that he will have in your schools and everything. Oh, y'all ain't saying nothing. Y'all ain't saying nothing. Because he knows without a doubt that not everybody is there for the wisdom and knowledge. Some people are just there because of the visions and loans they get. Is not there to humble himself and serve somebody. Somebody asked me something earlier today when I told them the Lord was calling them to servanthood. Oh, thank you, Apostle. I thank you for it. And they said nothing else to me. Because when I told them, the Lord said, go find who you're supposed to serve.
Wow. Come on, Apostle.
I said, because you cannot elevate until he deflates your ego.
Right.
Uh-oh.
Right.
Come on, Papa.
Oh, man.
He talks about, he lets Daniel know that he has sent Gabriel. Look at somebody and tell him Gabriel come.
Gabriel come.
Hallelujah. And I don't know about you, but I've been hearing horns.
Bells.
Bells and horns. Last night I heard.
Yeah.
And I license them, help them with the ordination and stuff. And the Lord began to let me see who they really were.
Come on,
because I went on their word. So I'm not licensing and ordaining anybody right now until you prove yourself.
Can you imagine?
And it's going to be more than 6 weeks. You can't prove yourself in 6 weeks. Character can't even be built in 6 weeks. It takes a while to build your character and cause your character to turn. Your gift is nothing if you don't have integrity and integrity and character working with it. You got to be honorable. I said you got to have honor before the people.
That's right.
In order for some people to even listen to you, they want to know, are you honorable? They're checking out your character, not your gift. You can prophesy, you can preach, you can do all that, but if your character is messed up, it overshadows everything else.
That's right.
Amen. And people getting upset, oh, they don't want to receive it. It's not you don't want to receive. They're not going to listen to you as long as you are the Lord. Your credibility has to be built.
That's right.
Now, see, I've been in ministry a long time. One thing people can say is she's always consistent. Mm-hmm. She's going to be who she is. And I didn't care what went down. When I lost everything, hugged and walked out on me, everything, I never stopped doing what God told me to do. I never let it affect me, and then I didn't get up and preach that every man was a dog. Like some of them do. Because I told them, I said, I don't care if 50,000 men hurt me. It's a 50,000 and one somewhere.
You never said it in a while.
Let me explain. It's a good man. It's a good man in the world. That devil is a lie. It's a good man. Hallelujah. And in this season, some good women that's really serving God.
Yes, right.
Huh? That haven't opened up the gates of hell. Come on now. But it's living holy. Come on now. Living holy. Come on now. Hallelujah. They ain't opened up for nobody else. Come on now. Hallelujah. God, get ready to bless them with husbands.
Come on, Apostle. Yes, Lord.
Some of your husband was displaced. You ought to be happy a hurricane came through. Sorry for the other stuff that happened, but you ought to be glad because you had to push your husband to where he was at. Looking at me, they were looking at me. Them folks in the car, one of them was crying. I sure wanted
Just finished listening to the media ministry of Apostle Barbara R. Thomas. You may write her at Apostle Barbara R. Thomas, P.O. Box 13291, Durham, North Carolina 27709. Thank you for supporting the ministry.